We're going in. Body cam. Assault group Beta, take southwest corridor. The rest of you on me. Collins, take point.
It looks pretty abandoned.
No contact yet. Wait. What the hell is that? Corporal, they're right on you. Fall back, Beta. Fall back.
Contact 12 o'clock.
Legions of Steel Operation Anvil is a fast-paced, hard sci-fi miniatures game set in the not-so-distant future. You will be controlling either the highly trained UNE Commando Troopers or the fearless machine forces comprised of G-12 Nightmare Robots and the dreaded Mark 7 Assault Fiend. The Legions of Steel core set comes with all the components needed to play, including 10 finely cast metal miniatures, 32 map tiles, allowing for thousands of map board configurations, action dice, doors, counters, core and tutorial rules, and numerous pre-generated scenarios. Playability is immense, as you can create your own scenarios time and again. Legions of Steel is played over a series of rounds, each comprised of an initiative segment, two player turns, and an end segment. At the beginning of each round, the players roll a d6, higher roller winning initiative. The player with the initiative decides who will have the first turn this round. The person whose turn it is considered the active player. The active player activates each of their figures, moving and attacking. Once a figure has been activated and its actions are finished, an action die is placed next to that figure to indicate its state. If the figure attacked, a fired symbol is placed next to it. If it did not fire, it is considered covering, which means that it is holding back its attack for future use, including during the opponent's turn. Attacking an opponent is accomplished through rolling a six-sided die, sometimes more depending on the weapon and your tactical decision. The roll must be equal to or higher than the weapon's two-hit number, and is modified by the range, attack modifiers, and the opponent's armor. If a roll is successful, the target is eliminated. There are various options for attacks, including auto-firing, spreading your attack to multiple targets, hand-to-hand engagement, and more, that add to the tactical decision process. In addition, some figures have extra abilities, like leadership or extra lives. With leadership, a sergeant figure can influence die results, allow troopers to move farther, or command them to attack out of turn. The Mark 7 Assault Fiend has an extra life, as it takes two hits to eliminate it from the game. The tactical decisions in this game are many, with plenty of player interactions. You will be jockeying your forces for tactical advantage, trying to get the upper hand from round to round. Additional rules, miniatures, and heroes are available, which expand the game's universe and add additional tactical decision-making. Thank you very much for checking out our video. I hope you enjoy our game.